Tony Khan 2 days ago said that AEW Double or Nothing was better than WrestleMania 37 this year. This got me thinking that was that really the case? But again, I love analyzing stuff and I'm gonna talk about AEW Double or Nothing results and spit out some facts for the AEW fanboys out there, which if you are listening, then reply to me in the comment section below. I'm just gonna give my honest opinion on every match of AEW Double or Nothing. Hangman Adam Page defeats Brian Cage. First of all, what is the FTW title? Why is it still around? And when will Hangman Adam Page join the Dark Order? He still calls them friends, right? But he hasn't joined them yet. I agree, there is a long-term storyline to this, but long-term storylines shouldn't be dragging so long. Either make him join the Dark Order or just make him just drink beers. Next one was the Young Bucks defeated John Moxley and Eddie Kingston. AEW promises that they will lift the tag team division, and yet here we are seeing singles wrestlers as tag teams like Kenny Omega and Hangman Adam Page, and now John Moxley and Eddie Kingston. Thankfully, John Moxley has taken a break and Eddie Kingston is doing his own stuff now. I'm glad that they didn't continue this. Jungle Boy wins the Casino Battle Royal. This was a really feel-good moment and the crowd popped huge for Jungle Boy. He deserved this. This was his moment. Miro defeated Lance Archer. Poor Lance Archer. That guy dominates all the time. He's a big dude. He dominates all the other matches, but he loses the big ones. I really hope there is a story over here. I just really hope. AEW is promising long-term storyline and whatnot, but Lance Archer is due a title win. He is losing big matches all the time. Next one was really good. Dr. Britt Baker defeated Hikaru Shida to become the new AEW Women's Champion. This was the only feel-good moment in the entire pay-per-view because Britt Baker deserved to win the AEW Women's title. She has worked very hard for that. That heel turn just saved her. Promo work top-notch. Wrestling, she is a really excellent wrestler. And I mean, this was really good. This was done very good. Sting and Darby Allin defeated Scorpio Sky and Ethan Page. Now, to all those people who criticize WWE of using part-timers and old guys like The Undertaker or even Goldberg, then why Sting wrestling? He shouldn't be wrestling, to be honest. He's 62. In fact, Goldberg and Undertaker are younger than Sting. 10 years younger. If you're gonna criticize the part-timers' usage in WWE, then do the same for AEW as well. Don't say, yeah, I like Sting. He's wrestling even now. It's Sting. Blah, blah, blah. No. Be honest. Don't be toxic. Don't be biased. Be honest about it. And next one was, oh my goodness, Kenny Omega defeated Orange Cassidy and Pac. Now, again, the same criticism. Kenny Omega used a roll-up to retain the AEW World title. And AEW fanboys criticized WWE over roll-up wins. Yes, WWE overuses the roll-up wins, the crucifix pinfalls and everything. But again, AEW has done the same thing. And finally, Inner Circle wins the Stadium Stampede. This was mind-boggling. This match didn't make sense because the Pinnacle already won the feud at Blood and Guts. So this match was just pointless. And the craziest part here is they are still dragging this bloody feud. Why? You don't need this feud. Just move on. Maybe Inner Circle sticks together, but let them do their own thing. Chris Jericho goes after the world title again. Sammy Guevara goes for the TNT title. Santana and Ortiz go for the tag titles. Do something with them. It's just a bunch of talent getting wasted inside a faction. And for all this, Tony Khan says AEW Double or Nothing was better. I don't mean to be rude, to be honest, but the crowd reaction tells a different story. WrestleMania 37 sounded more lively to me than Double or Nothing. But with all that being said, AEW shouldn't be compared to WWE or with any other company. I feel that diehard AEW fans are possibly the most toxic fans out there just by looking at some of the Twitter comments and the YouTube comments. But then, was AEW Double or Nothing better than WrestleMania 37? Well, yes and no at the same time. Yes, because there were two feel-good moments in the form of Britt Baker finally winning the AEW Women's title and Jungle Boy winning the Casino Battle Royal because he deserved it. And no, because Kenny Omega retained by a roll-up finish, Young Bucks faced a tag team of singles wrestlers, and Lance Archer losing the big matches all the time. The match quality has never been a question at both AEW and WWE. But again, you may question me that, you are criticizing AEW Double or Nothing, but was WrestleMania 37 good? Again, yes and no at the same time. First, the build-up to the WrestleMania 37 was the worst build-up of all time. I made an entire video on this. But Bianca Belair winning the SmackDown Women's title, Bobby Lashley retaining the WWE title, Bad Bunny's stunning WrestleMania debut, and the domination of Roman Reigns in the main event of WrestleMania made it worth the watch. So both the pay-per-views were good and bad at the same time. So people shouldn't consider Tony Khan's statement that AEW Double or Nothing was better than WrestleMania. Both were good, both were bad at the same time. This is my thoughts. This is my honest opinion on whether AEW Double or Nothing was better than WrestleMania 37. Yeah, if you like this video, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you guys in the next one.